Hello, Lenny here with the English language session 3. So we start the session today, and the answer to this would be at the end of the session. What's the difference in meaning? I injured my finger, I have injured my finger, and I had injured my finger. So just think how they are different in meaning, not the tenses, but in meaning. So we come to our first section of pronunciation. These are a few words that are mispronounced by people. The first word is pronounced as innocent, innocent, not innocent. The second word, by the spelling, it seems like debris, but it's pronounced as debris. Like when a building is destroyed and the unwanted material, so that is called debris, not debris. The third word is conscience. I heard some people pronouncing it as conscience, but it's not conscience, it's conscience. This is not H, it is H. You pronounce it as H. This is an insect and you cannot make it your aunt. It's pronounced as ant and not aunt. The second last word for today is informative. Informative. You are not going to say informative. You'll pronounce it as informative. And the last word is crooked. Crooked means not straight. You'll not say crooked, but you'll say crooked. So we come to our next section of error analysis. The first sentence, that is a good book. Its title is attractive. It's time we should read it. Are there any mistakes or errors in it? Yes. You see, it's with apostrophe and it's without apostrophe. So, it's with apostrophe means it is. It does not mean possession. If it's a noun, an apostrophe like Ali's bag, so then that means it's a possession. But with pronouns, we do not put apostrophe for possessions. So when we are saying its title, it's talking about the title of the book. So then we will not write an apostrophe. So there'll be no apostrophe. And here when we say it's time, it means it is time. It's the contraction of it is, short form. So here there should be an apostrophe. The next sentence, we believe on God. This is incorrect to say we believe on God. We should say we believe in God. The next one, I go to this tuition center. Any error in that? Yes, there's a spelling mistake and I've seen on many tuition center, even on the boards, this spelling is there. So this is not tuition, but it becomes tuition. So it should be T-U-I, T-U-I-T-I-O-N. So this is the spelling mistake in this sentence. The next one, among all my books, I like Wuthering Heights better. Now you see, better is a comparative degree when we are comparing two. But here it's talking about among all the books. So then we have to use the superlative degree. So among all my books, I like Wuthering Heights the best. Okay, it's the best among all. It's not, we are not comparing two. If we compare two, then we'll use the comparative degree better. And the last sentence, the meeting will be held between 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. If this sentence was, the meeting will be held from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m., that has a different meaning. It means the meeting will start from 4 p.m. and it will end at 6 p.m. But here they are talking about between. It's not starting at 4 and it's not ending at 6. The meeting can be any time between this time. So you'll say the meeting will be held between 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. So in between, the meeting can take place anytime. If it is from, then you'll say from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. And if it's between, then you'll say between 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. Thank you. So we come to the last section of our vocabulary section, and today the words are more or less related to crime. The first word is handcuffs. So we see that people or criminals are arrested by a metal ring. So those are called handcuffs. It's a noun and it's also a verb. You can say the police handcuffed the criminal. And if it's not on the hands, then the metal that is on the legs, so that is called fetters. Fetters. The next word is adultery. Now there's a difference in the word adultery and fornication. It seems, and people sometimes use it interchangeably, but there's a slight difference. Adultery means having sexual relationships when a married person, out of his marriage, if he has a sexual relationship, so that's adultery. And if an unmarried person has a sexual relationship with another person, so that is fornication. The last word is illegitimate child. Illegitimate child is a child that is born out of a wedlock. If people are not married and they have a child, so that's called an illegitimate child. So you'll see other words related to crime on the next slide. Now I come to the answer of the question that I asked in the beginning. What's the difference between I injured my finger, I have injured my finger, and I had injured my finger? I injured my finger means the finger was injured somewhere in the past, but it's no more injured. The effect is not seen in the present. I have injured my finger is the present perfect tense. It means a recent thing that happened. So the finger was recently injured and the impact is still on the finger. And I had injured my finger means the finger was injured even before the past. Okay, then I'll see you in session 4 very soon. Take care, and I hope you have learned something from these sessions. Bye-bye.